and a sign that this has come before the great and terrible day of the Lord that is going to come. So one of the things that is going to take place after this sign is a separation of the sheep from the goats, the wheat from the tares, the good from the bad, and the righteous from the unrighteous, the godly from the ungodly. A separation will take place. That is a sign, one of the works that is going to take place. You know, angels have been released all over the face of this earth to mark out what you just read in Ezekiel chapter 9. They've gone out upon all the face of the world in every church to set a mark upon those who are the truly godly ones. How to identify the truly godly ones? Ezekiel 9 tells us very clearly, they are the ones who sigh and moan and groan for the sins of the city. They sigh and they groan and they cry, they weep and they cry. It's not like they who just see and walk away, don't care. Like what most people's attitudes are today. We see something, we just walk away. Why bother? Why care? It's not my problem. It's not my family. Why bother? Even if it's your own family, you still don't bother. Oh, they're living on their own. Why should I bother? Why care? That's the attitude many people have. Such people, they will not receive the mark. But those who care, like the good shepherd who's always caring for this sheep, who's always thinking about his sheep. You know, 1 Peter 5:7 says, cast all your cares upon you, for he thinks about you. But another translation says, he's constantly thinking about you. You are constantly on his mind, on his heart. That's what a good shepherd is. Constantly thinking about one another. And then you sigh and you pray. And you mourn and you cry before God. Oh Lord, save our city. Oh Lord, save our nation. Those are the true godly ones that will be marked and set apart. Now such people are going to be anointed with this last day's powers of God. Now, how will this power of God come or look like? In the scriptures, we have some examples or some samples of the manifestation of the power of God. Let's look at a few manifestations. Firstly, in Exodus chapter 19, verses 16 to 18 records the very first